Okay, guys, we are here with a very with an amazing singer, Anushka Manchanda. She's one of my favorites. She's not just a singer, she's a hardcore performer and a rock star. And I have seen her since her Viva. What were your, you were in Channel?
Viva, Channel V.
Channel V. And what was the name of the group?
Viva.
Viva, yeah. Okay, so we are here with her. And I was so happy to hear that she has gone vegan. Yes, she's gone vegan. Okay. And I would like to hear from her, what was her story before she went vegan? What was her lifestyle before she went vegan? And then 2 minutes on why she went vegan.
Okay, so I'm a Punjabi from Delhi.
Oh.
And we grew up eating parathas and butter chicken and all yeah. that, you know, seekh kebab and all that. And while I was growing up, I never thought about this vegetarian, non-vegetarian, it didn't matter. I knew people who were vegetarian.
Yeah.
I just found it strange that they didn't eat meat, you know, but I didn't question it.
Yeah.
And I always spoke about how much I loved animals.
Okay.
I never made the connection, you know.
Okay.
Like, it's so bizarre that we are so conditioned, the way that we are brought up, that, you know, there is some things that are just there that we don't even question, which don't make any sense.
Yeah.
And so, it happened very slowly, and I think that, you know, I said this to someone before also, that becoming vegan has been a journey, you know, and I think everyone has a journey and everyone has a different journey.
Yeah.
And for me, it began the day that I heard in Goa, I was there, I was working, and I heard a pig being slaughtered. Pork used to be my favorite meat.
Oh.
And it didn't stop, you know, that crying for like a few minutes, and a few minutes is a long time, you know.
Okay.
2.5 minutes.
You heard the pig crying for.
Yes.
You were crying for 2.5 minutes.
No, I heard the
pig crying.
Crying, and it was the most horrible sound I've ever heard in my life.
Yes.
And I was sitting and crying. Like we were shooting something and we had to stop. And I was at that point. I was like, I'm never gonna eat pork again. Pork, beef, everything has stopped. Chicken has stopped. Even dairy.
Huh.
3 years ago, actually, chicken, dairy, pork, everything I stopped because I started watching the videos that were showing up on my timeline. At first, I was avoiding looking at these videos, you know. But then I thought to myself, like, I'm becoming those people that I hate. The people who, you know, wear blinders or actually refuse to see the truth about things. And I thought to myself that, you know what, if this is the food that I'm eating. I need to know where it's coming from, and I should watch these videos.
Yeah.
If I watch these videos and I'm cool with it, I'll continue eating meat. If I watch it and it affects me a certain way, then you see. But I can't do this.
Yes.
I have to see this.
You have to know this.
And then after I watched it, I was like, man, I don't want to be a part of this, causing so much suffering and pain. I don't want to do this.
Yeah.
Because I really do love animals.
And what were your favorite, from there you went, and from what were your favorite foods before you turned vegan?
I used to love, there were 2-3 things, you know, that I was eating, that I enjoyed. There was butter chicken, I used to really like a no-brainer.
Yeah.
Means anywhere you go, late night, another city, whatever, you just order butter chicken, the easiest thing.
Okay.
And seekh kebab rolls, these were the things that I really liked.
Uh-huh.
Cheese, I ate so much cheese.
You ate so much cheese.
Milk, it was still less, you don't really consume
but
it.
But cheese
so
is something that adults consume a
cheese
lot.
Cheese was
yes.
a lot of cheese, I really enjoyed it, you know.
Yeah.
And the funny thing is that I actually made the switch to, I was still only eating fish, but no meat, no dairy. While I was traveling abroad, I was in Germany, we were on some kind of work tour. And it was far easier for me to be vegan there, you know. Or semi, not vegan, like, that's not the right word. But they were options for me.
Yeah.
I didn't have to, you know, struggle or... every restaurant had an option for me.
And Germany was supposed to be, till last year, it was known as the vegan capital of the world. So they have lots
so
of...
So many options. Then, when I came back and I, you know, I've seen this growth in the last 2 years, actually.
In India.
And more than anything, in the last 1 year.
In the last
really
1 year.
It's blown up. Like everyone knows what being vegan is. Like, people know what veganism is.
Yeah.
I don't have to explain in a restaurant anymore.
Yeah.
You know, that,
and you have gone vegan in which month of this?
Well,
2018, right?
2018. Now it's been about a year, I would say.
Okay, great.
Approximately. But before... I don't know why in my mind, you know, somehow, somewhere it was like fish is okay.
Yes.
Because fish is not suffering. The fish is in the water. They pull it out at one go and the fish is dead and then you eat it.
Yes.
There's no prolonged suffering. Then I watched Blue Planet. And I realized how intelligent fish are and how smart they are and how stupid I am to think that, are it's okay, wo suffer to nahi karte, but... So that was the time when I made the full switch, but leather, makeup, skincare and all, I started that long ago.
So nice. So now how do you feel after going vegan?
I said this and I keep saying it's my favorite line to say, but I feel that my third eye is open.
Wow.
I feel more in tune with my surroundings, I feel more aware, I feel more connected to nature, to the universe. It's crazy. Like, how all that is happening, I feel more energetic.
So nice.
You know,
so nice.
I feel full of life and I really feel I feel different from before.
Wow.
This is for sure.
Very nice. And your message to the people who haven't gone vegan yet or who...
So I will say, don't be hard on yourself. Every little bit counts. So even if you start, say you're eating meat like 4 times a week, drop it to once a week or twice a week. Try it. Or try a vegan diet for 21 days.
Yes.
And check it out.
Check it out.
Try the diet and maybe you slip once, twice, whatever. You're saying, okay, I'm going to be vegan from now on. But then like after 2 weeks, you ate a chicken sandwich. It's fine.
As far as you're trying to make a change,
yes, keep,
please make the effort.
Yeah, keep going, it will all come. You know, don't be hard on yourself and look for support. I think
yes.
This is one of the most important things, you know, to be able to find other people like yourself.
Yes.
Like now I feel so good because I know so many people, there are so many, there's a big network.
Yes.
You just plug yourself into that network and it becomes easier. You get the motivation also to stay, you know, to stay committed, and you get ideas also, tips also, you know, and sometimes when you're feeling like depressed or you're feeling bad, you get like some moral support also. So you just find your tribe.
Yeah. So good effort from Anushka to have made the change. And the reason, there are plenty of vegans all around over here, but the reason I took your video is because you're a known face and a popular face, so your message will be seen by many other people.
Yes.
You know, and I really hope your message goes across to others.
Yes, I hope so.
And I hope you come across very strongly as a vegan in front of the media also now.
Yes.
And thanks for giving the permission for shooting.
Yes.
Because this is going to go live on Facebook. And I hope many people get inspired by you.
Hope
Anushka was a hardcore Punjabi non-vegetarian, guys. So please make the change, make the connect and make the switch. Okay? Thank you and happy vegan years.
Whee!
Yes, go vegan. Okay? Thank you. Thank you.